So we've now heard from a leading international expert, and it's time to hear from some of our local Australian industry specialists. And our first topic is the future of talent management. So no matter how the future of work changes and evolves over the next decade, one constant will remain. A business will not outlast and outperform its competitors without recruiting and retaining the best talent. And as we've just heard, especially the creative, socially intelligent and perceptive ones. As Michael Osborne has shown us, big data has revolutionised nearly every field of business. And now we will explore how big data will transform the world of talent management over the next decade. You may be wondering, how will employers use big data to find, filter and assess candidates? How will people hear about and apply for jobs? And what impact will big data have on the human element of talent management? To speak with us on this topic, we have Andrea Tjoeng. Andrea is the global business leader of Scout Recruitment Software, an international organisation specialising in candidate management and talent management software designed to help companies attract and recruit the best people to their teams. With a background in management, sales and marketing, Andrea is one of the Australian Institute of Management's AIM 30 2014 alumni, which recognises managers under the age of 30 years who have excelled in their profession. Andrea was also recognised as one of Ant Hill's top 30 under 30 entrepreneurs in 2013. Andrea's passion lies in remaining at the forefront of the ever-changing recruitment market and providing technology that matches top talent with forward-thinking businesses. Please welcome Andrea Tjoeng.
Did you know that over 54% of people stretch the truth when they're applying for a job? On average, it takes 25 days to fill a vacant position. And if you're in a company with more than 5,000 staff, that's actually 58 working days. 22% of new hires leave their job within 2 months of being appointed. 46% of new hires leave their jobs within 18 months. The costs of employee turnover range from 30% to 150% of that person's salary. Talent management is critical to the success of any organisation. Without the best people on our team, we can't provide the best service to our customers or to our community. We won't outlast or outperform our competition. But recruitment and talent management are also really, really hard. It's no wonder that PwC's latest CEO survey shows that 74% of Australian CEOs list the availability of key skills as one of their top threats to business growth. But what if I told you that next time you were to hire someone in your business, or next time you were involved in a recruitment process, there was a way to make the entire process not just faster, but much more likely to succeed? A way to make sure that the next hire you bring on is not only the best person for the role, but someone who is going to stay, succeed, and take your company to new heights. You'll find that we're already heading down this path in talent management thanks to what we call big data. Now, we've heard about big data already, but the way that I like to think of it is that it describes huge amounts of data gathered from a wide variety of sources, internal and external to our companies, which can be mined to create insights that will drive our businesses forward. If anyone in the audience is wondering what puts the big in big data, consider this. 90% of all of the data in the world was created in the past 2 years. And that's set to double every 2 years from here on in. Many businesses are already using big data for marketing and for advertising. We can probably all think of some examples, but one that comes to my mind is Netflix, which actually just launched in Australia today, I believe. So Netflix will monitor which movies and which TV shows we watch. It will remember that. And then next time we use Netflix, it will make recommendations as to what we might like to watch. Another great example is Expedia. I use Expedia a lot to book hotels, and every time I jump on, Expedia remembers who I am and which cities I'm visiting, which hotels I'm choosing, which ones I'm not choosing. And it's using this data to make informed predictions as to my age, whether or not I'm in a relationship, if I have kids, even how much money I earn. Again, next time I use Expedia, it tailors its offerings to suit me, which results in a better buying experience and makes me more likely to use Expedia in the future. So big data isn't new necessarily, but a new application for big data is emerging, and it's specifically being used for talent management. Why would we use big data for talent management? Well, up until now, a lot of the decisions made in recruitment and talent management have been based on previous experience or, if I'm being honest, gut feel or instinct. But big data for talent management will help to educate our decisions and ultimately help us make more informed, data-driven decisions around our recruitment and our people once they come on board. We'll often refer to big data for the use of talent management as people analytics. There's a really great case study, actually, in this to be found in Xerox. So Xerox recruit about 50,000 call center workers across the US, and their old way of recruitment involved looking at an application, they'd read through the resume, and they'd look specifically for people who had previous experience in a similar role. Because why wouldn't you? You know, your logic would think that someone who has experience is going to be good for this job. And they'd bring those people in for an interview. But Xerox had a really big problem, and that was in turnover. They were having huge amounts of turnover in their call center staff, and it was costing the business millions of dollars. So they decided to take a people analytics approach. And what they did was they examined the data of the people they brought into the business who left within those first 3 months. And they also examined the data of the people they brought in who stayed and went on to do well and succeed. And with all of this data, they created a screening test used at the application stage that ultimately would determine or predict whether or not someone was likely to stay if they were to be hired. Some of the findings were really interesting. One was particularly quirky, and it was that candidates who use one or two social networks, maybe if they use Facebook and Instagram, they're more likely to stay than those who use three or more. So if you use Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, you're less likely to work out at Xerox. But others were more fundamental. Namely, this data showed Xerox that the chances of someone staying and succeeding in the role had nothing to do with whether or not that person had prior experience. Nothing to do with it at all. So what are the results? Well, since implementing this big data strategy in their recruitment, Xerox has reduced their attrition by 20%. And promotions are on the rise. And hiring managers are going as far as to say to HR, we don't need to interview anyone, just give me their score. So the next question is how? What are some of the practical applications of big data in recruitment and talent management? If we take a look at the traditional recruitment workflow, with all of this big data at our disposal, I predict that in the future, we might say goodbye to the job board. When we're hiring someone, it won't be a matter of hopping onto Seek and placing a job board ad and wishing and hoping that the right person is going to see that ad and apply for the role. Instead, each of our businesses will have its own personalised, comprehensive talent pool database within which we can tap into. Now, I know talent pooling isn't new, but the difference is that big data is going to dramatically improve the quality and the quantity of data we have, both from internal and external sources. And it's also going to make it much easier to keep the people in our talent pools engaged. The talent pool of the future will allow us to proactively find people with the right skills and experience and temperament and personality and cultural fit. And it's also going to analyse the signals that someone might be open to being approached about a new role. So let's say you've had a terrible day at work and you hop onto a particular blog or you start looking at certain websites. That might flag your profile in an employer's talent pool, and they might then contact you to see if you're interested in jumping ship. When it comes to the screening, in the future, we will say goodbye to the traditional two-page PDF resume. Each of us will have our own online profile, which will talk about our skills, our experience, again, our behaviour, our temperament. Every deal within a company will be attributed to the right people, and it will appear on your profile. Every promotion will be noted in real time. Perhaps someone's online profile will even rate you as to how engaged you are with an employer brand or how interested you are in that company. And again, that's based on your research, your internet activity. I think that to get a job in the future, it's going to be less and less about perfecting your CV, but more about considering the footprint that you're leaving behind in cyberspace. At stage three in the interview process, we'll be far more informed about a candidate prior to when they come in. So there's going to be no need for the, let's face it, they're somewhat inane interview questions such as, what do you like to do in your spare time? We will know that information, but we can use the time in an interview far more effectively to validate the data that we've gathered and the assumptions that we've made around that person. At the reference check stage, I think there'll be no need for a phone-based reference check, no need to call up those previous employers. We'll have an employer's assessment of the candidate in front of us. It will be available online, and I'll tell you a story about that one in just a moment. But so far, I've focused on the recruitment side of talent management, and I think it's worth appreciating that people analytics will definitely impact retention and talent management strategies once someone comes into a business. So, for example, we could examine why some of our top employees have left our organisation, and then we can use that data to improve our compensation and our work environment to make it more likely that the next group of people we bring in are going to stay with us and perform. A little while ago, I needed to hire someone within my business. And I think it's worth sharing this story because it's a good example of how, while we might not be quite there yet with all of these people analytics concepts I've spoken about, we're really not far off. So I had to hire someone within my business, and I was looking for a digital marketing specialist. And as a business owner, I think recruitment comes with lots of ups and downs. So I was really excited about the thought of what this person could bring to my business, but it was really, really tough. So I started by putting an ad up on Seek, like most of us do, and within a couple of days, I'd received about 50 applications, which was great. People want to work with me. That's awesome. Great people out there. But then I had to read through each application, and I was looking at CVs, and I was looking at their answers to my screening questions, and I had to try to figure out, based on a couple of pieces of paper, why someone would be good for my business and what they could offer. A lot of the people who looked good on paper didn't perform once they came in and I met with them face to face. And there was one person who was really good at the interview stage, but then I spent days trying to get a hold of their reference checks, only to speak with a previous employer who made me decide not to proceed with that person. So I was back to square one. And then a colleague suggested I try Elance. Now, for anyone who doesn't know, Elance is an online hiring website, and it connects employers with freelancers in Australia and all around the world. So I jumped onto Elance and I posted my job, and I could list what kind of skills I was looking for and experience and what type of person I wanted. And within seconds, I was presented with a wide number of people all around the world who met my brief and who could be suitable for my team. But the thing that really stood out to me was the amount of data that was available on each candidate. Namely, I could see exactly how their previous employers had scored their work. I could see how they'd scored their work and what work they'd done for them and who their employers were. So I had Lou, and Lou had a score of 3.5 out of 5, so I crossed him off the list. It's a bit cutthroat by that stage. And then I saw Jenny, and Jenny had a score of 4.9 out of 5, but she'd only done two other jobs, so maybe there wasn't enough data to really validate that score. And then I came across Peter, and Peter had a score of 4.8, and he'd completed dozens of similar roles for other employers. Like I said, I could see who'd employed him, what work he'd done, how they'd scored him, and what the outcomes were. This data helped me make an informed, educated decision as to who I was going to bring into my business. I did hire Pete, by the way, and he's still with me, and he's great. One interesting area that we don't have time to explore in detail today is the fact that as much as we're going to use data to research and assess our candidates, so too will the candidates on us. Candidates with the rise of big data will be able to see more and more about our businesses, how they're performing. They'll be able to research us personally as hiring managers, and they'll decide whether or not they want to work with us prior to applying. The quality and quantity of this data is only going to improve, but we're already seeing examples of it. For example, we've got Whirlpool and we've got Glassdoor already online where people can compare notes and talk about what it's like to work for that employer, what the interview process is like. Imagine those sites in 2 years or 5 years or 10 years. They're going to evolve dramatically. So where to from here? Well, first of all, this cartoon is a little tongue-in-cheek. I don't believe analytics will ever be a complete replacement for the human element in talent management, but I do believe that big data is going to be invaluable to us in supporting our decision-making. Professor Osborne talked a little bit about some of the jobs of the future, and I think a job of the future that we'll see a rise in will be the talent data analyst who specialises in people analytics. And I think this role will be invaluable to any business. Businesses like Scout are already working on technology that will take some of what I've spoken about today from the conceptual to an everyday reality. Hopefully, the work that we're doing in this space is going to reduce or improve some of the statistics that I shared earlier. If you'd like more information, please get in contact with me, and thank you for your time today.